you and your individual are going to get married, could you tell me some of the stories from before?
Sure, let me get the photo album. Okay, so when we were young, Mom used to dress Andrew up like a little Japanese schoolboy.
No, I mean the exciting story is like how you got Andrew and Jojo met.
I think I have a few photos here. Andrew actually told me that the first time they met was at a dinner with mutual friends.
But Joe doesn't really remember the event, so I guess it doesn't really count.
So, how did they properly meet then?
The two of them actually started getting to know each other over the internet.
Andrew was still studying in Australia at the time, so he used to have to stay up pretty late in order to meet Joe on the internet.
Joe never realized that the 2, sometimes 3 hour time difference between Singapore and Sydney meant that Andrew would have to stay up till 4 in the morning in order to chat with her. But he didn't mind.
He was so glad he found the one he'd been looking for.
My mom doesn't allow me to stay up so late at night.
Well, your mom is right. You should always try to get a good night's sleep every night.
So, is that how they fell in love?
Actually, although they really liked talking to each other, they were different people.
You see, my brother is a geek. And he would spend most of his time at home with his gamer friends, playing on his Xbox or watching Star Wars on DVD. Joe, on the other hand, was an outgoing kind of girl who partied a lot and hung out with lots of really happening people, like DJs and musicians.
So, how did they finally start dating?
I think it was December 2003 when Andrew finally finished uni and came back to Singapore.
He was so excited about seeing Joe that the very next day after he landed, he went to visit her at her work. One thing led to another, and soon they started officially dating. It wasn't easy at first, but eventually they got past their differences. They even started playing video games together. In return, Andrew started taking Joe out to places she wanted to go, and bought her lots of stuff like shoes and bags. Learning from each other opened up whole new worlds for both.
Take you wonder by wonder, over sideways, under, on a magic carpet ride.
A whole new world.
Don't you dare close your eyes.
100 miles.
Hold your breath
to see. I'm like a shooting star. I've come so far. I can't go back to where I used to be.
Let me share this whole new world with you. A whole new world.
A whole new world.
That's where we'll be.
That's where we'll be.
Thrilling chase. For you and me.
That sounds so magical. So, how did Pika and Andrew propose to Sister Joe? I heard he proposed to her next to the rubbish bin.
No. Who told you that nonsense?
Sister Joe.
She's just bluffing you. Actually, that's the part where the story has a twist.
Bye, I'm going.
Okay, don't come home too late.
Okay, I won't.
Hey, don't forget to lock the gate.
Don't worry la.
Iago, what are you doing here?
Who's Iago? Iago was Joe's ex-boyfriend. Apparently, he didn't really approve of Joe's new relationship.
I have a bad feeling about this.
I've been looking so long at these pictures of you that I almost believe that they're real.
We're broken up now, Iago.
Oh, can't you see that you belong to me? My poor heart aches with every step you take.
Go away and leave me alone. I'm not the one for you.
If you're not the one, then why does my soul feel glad today, huh? Besides, I'm a rock star now, and you like musicians.
Actually, you're just a drummer. And you cheated on me, Iago. You cheated on me and hurt me.
Come on. I've looked back on the things that I've done, and I realized that I was only trying to be someone. But those days are over. Let me show you the shape of my heart.
I think you should leave.
No. I'll never let go.
Oh no, that's horrible. What did he do with Tito Joe?
After that, he took her away to the secret lair far, far away, where he kept her there as prisoner.
Joe? Hang in there, I'm gonna get you out of here.
Look out behind you!
Eat this, you piece of crap, cushions!
I raised an army for this woman. I gave my soul to the demons of hell for her. So tell me, what would you do for love?
I would do anything for love, but I won't do that!
Die!
You're a monster, Iago.
I don't care who I am, and I don't care what I do. As long as she love me. Die!
You could kill me 1,000 times, but she will never love you!
No! She loves me! I know it!
Hey, Iago! Don't touch me with a tainted love.
Are you sure he didn't propose to her next to a rubbish bin?
Yeah, I didn't just make all that up, you know.
Then what happened next?
Well, this is the part where they live happily ever after.